Facts First presents. Dog passes away after owner fed it dog food that contained a euthanasia drug. First, help us out by clicking that like button, and also be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. If you have a dog at home, you should take a look at the food and treats in your pantry. This is because there are several lines of dog food that contain traces of euthanasia drugs. Sadly, a number of dogs have died already. Nikki Mail, she went through this. Her dog passed away after being fed one of these popular dog foods. The FDA has found this euthanasia drug in several food brands. Nikki had 5 dogs, and this day was the same as most. She fed each of her dogs a can of Evanger's pet food. Well, about 15 minutes after eating it, each of her dogs became very ill, and sadly, one of her dogs, Tallulah, died. According to Nikki, shortly after feeding the dogs, they were all falling over. They were running into walls and having seizures. She says that she had never been more frightened in her life for her dogs. Well, Nikki wanted to know what caused her dogs to become ill like that and what took her precious Tallulah away from her. So she decided to send the rest of the food to a lab to be analyzed. And when the results of the test came back, she was floored. The test showed that her dogs had been poisoned. There were traces of a drug called pentobarbital in the dog food. It's the same drug that vets use to euthanize dogs, cats, and horses. The drug being in this pet food, it violates the Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act. Kind of makes you wonder why it would be in the food to begin with. Well, when Nikki's story got out, Channel 12 News got involved, and they had a variety of pet foods tested, and what they found was shocking. The drug was found not only in Evanger's, but also Gravy Train. And these are the companies who make Meow Mix, Milkbone, Kibbles and Bits, 9 Lives, Natural Balance, Pup Peroni, Gravy Train, Nature's Recipe, Canine Carryouts, Milo's Kitchen, Alley Cat, Jerky Treats, Meaty Bone, Pounce, and Snossages. According to the FDA, pets who eat food containing this drug can experience dizziness, drowsiness, excitement, loss of balance, nausea, inability to stand, and eyes moving back and forth in a jerking manner. And then, of course, consuming high levels of the drug can result in coma and death. Why would this ever be included in the food to begin with? Nikki, probably like the rest of us, couldn't believe what she had just heard. Not only was one of her dogs dead and the others left gravely ill, but other dogs and cats, they were also at risk of suffering the same fate. Well, when the test results were released, the J.M. Smucker Company, they recalled all shipments of Gravy Train, Kibbles and Bits, Old Roy, and Skippy canned dog food. The company released a statement saying, "The company has identified the cause to be a single supplier and a single minor ingredient used at one manufacturing facility. Above all, we are a company that loves pets and understand the responsibility we have in providing high-quality food for the pets our consumers love." Well, Nikki was happy that the company is responsible for taking the necessary steps to keep pets safe, but she wishes that they would have figured out what the problem was before she fed her dogs this tainted food. Had she known about the recall earlier, she of course would have thrown the food away, and if she had done that, her precious Tallulah would still be here. Well, after her dogs fell ill, an online crowdfunding page was set up to help her pay the vet bills for her dogs who were still sick. Nikki's friend Lisa Walters created the page with a goal of $5,800, which was the total cost of the vet bill. The site earned about $8,000. Sadly, Lisa had to shut the page down, though, while people were still donating. There were complaints online that Nikki may have poisoned the dog herself. Some people thought that Nikki had a party and the dogs got into cakes and sweets. A woman in Utah was so sure that the food was fine, she took a video of her dog eating the food and it did not get sick. Well, when the news came out about the drug in the food, Nikki was finally vindicated. People had no choice but to believe that her dogs were actually ill. Unfortunately, none of this is going to bring her beloved Tallulah back. Nikki says that she's just glad the companies involved found out about their tainted food before too many other pets died. Subscribe for more!